guys, it's Ruby, back again with another Las Vegas video. Today, I wanna talk about my top overrated sites in Las Vegas. This is gonna be a little bit of a controversial one. If you guys like Vegas content and you are not a subscriber, you can go ahead and click subscribe. And if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. This is just my opinion. These are just the things that I think you could maybe skip. There's so much to do in Las Vegas, and sometimes I think it can get overwhelming to try to plan a trip. To me, these are the things that I think you would totally be fine not seeing, or that maybe aren't worth the trip. These might be somebody else's absolute must-dos, and if they are yours, go ahead and leave a comment and let me know why you think that these are absolute musts. Everybody has a different opinion, but to me, these are ones that I just think aren't really worth your time. Okay, so disclaimer out of the way. Some of these are gonna be like a little bit of controversy, maybe stir up a lot of comments, but my number one for overrated is gonna be the Chandelier Bar. So this is a gorgeous, gorgeous bar.
Wait, you just dissed me? I'm perplexed.
I'm not gonna say it's not beautiful, and I definitely think you should stop into the Cosmopolitan and take a picture in front of the Chandelier Bar, but I have gone here twice, and both times I had horrible service. Like, the servers were just incredibly rude. And this isn't the only place where I'm gonna mention service as a big deal, because it matters a lot to me when you're in a tipping town or a place where you're expected to have great service to then just be treated sort of rudely. I feel like the Cosmopolitan in general really kind of treats you like you're just one of another guests, and they won't miss you if you're not there. And for that reason alone, I just think this isn't a must do. I feel like I get treated a lot better at a lot of the other bars and have a lot of friendly service, and they are just as Instagrammable and just as fun as the Chandelier Bar. So the drinks I've had there were okay, but overall, I think this place is super overrated, and it's just not somewhere that I recommend people to go.
You disgust me. How can you live with yourself?
Okay, let's talk about number two, the Container Park. So on every single Pinterest Las Vegas must-do list I've looked at, and I've looked at a lot, every single one of them puts the Container Park on. I hadn't been there for so many trips because we just never made our way out there, and I kept thinking, we have to do the Container Park. We haven't gone yet. And you know what? I thought it was kind of skippable. Honestly, you guys, the Container Park is built out of these shipping containers, and inside are bars and restaurants, and they're all sort of surrounded by a playground and a stage. Now, to me, if I was like a local, this would be a really cool place to go as a local, I feel like. Especially if you have kids, because they have this big playground in the middle where the kids can play while adults are kind of like having a drink at a bar. But for a tourist, I didn't think this place was really worth the extra hike. It's off Fremont Street in downtown. It's like a few blocks away from the Fremont Street experience. And we just weren't that impressed. I had a pretty okay lunch here. My husband's lunch was really mediocre.
Meatloaf, double meatloaf.
And overall, I just felt like this wasn't a must-do. This wasn't a place that we needed to go out of our way to go to. And so for that reason, I feel like if you have a really packed schedule, I think the Container Park is a definite skip. Okay, number three. This is the one where if I don't get a couple comments telling me I'm so wrong, then I don't even know what to say. But the MGM Grand, I think, is extremely overrated, you guys. So I have seen old videos of the MGM Grand in the 80s and the 90s when they had that giant lion and there were actual lions in the lobby and they had the Wizard of Oz theme in the lobby, and all of that was so awesome. Today, I just feel like it has been stripped of like all of its character, and it is like not even worth going in. There's really no theme. And someone's gonna laugh at me because I had a comment, someone asking me, what is your deal with smells? But to me, like, smell is one of the biggest scent memories to me, and it helps me tie into a place. The MGM Grand smells bad.
You stink.
The MGM Grand smells like smoke of a variety of kinds.
Just looking into your soul, man.
And like damp, like musty carpet. It's not a good smell. It smells really bad in there, you guys. And the MGM Grand just has these really weird groups. Like, there's like party goers and like those people with the big yard long drinks, but then there's like a bunch of families with kids. It's just a weird crowd. It's a huge place and it's weirdly set up. It doesn't smell very good. I am just not a fan of the MGM Grand, you guys. Let me know in the comments if it is like a nostalgia thing for you or if I'm missing something. I know I haven't stayed there, but as far as like when I do my hotel hopping and I like to go and check out all the casinos and stuff, I always skip the MGM Grand. I don't really even like the gaming in there. I'm just not a big fan. And that one might be a really personal one, but I got really hyped up to go there. And when I saw the outside in the beautiful emerald color, I was kind of excited to go in. And I was left underwhelmed. So for that reason, I think the MGM Grand is on my overrated list.
I knew it was you. I could smell you getting off the elevator.
Okay, this next one is actually a place I really like. So I know it's weird to put it on my overrated list, but to me, this place is super, super hyped, and I don't necessarily consider it a must-do, even though I really like it, and that is Vanderpump Cocktail Garden. So this is like the newest hit thing in Vegas that like a lot of the millennials and the Gen Xers are trying to go to. It's extremely Instagrammable. They have probably the most Instagram-worthy cocktails, but I don't think this place is worth a huge line. So I've waited up to an hour to get in here and I wouldn't personally do it again. It's a really small lounge. It's very small. The outside of it actually hangs outside in the casino. So you're kind of on the casino floor and they do put these beautiful topiaries and beautiful like flowers to try to give you a feel that you are transported elsewhere. But you still feel like you're on a casino floor. I've gone here like a handful of times and never sat on the inside because it's just so small that you can't actually get in there. Now, I think the drinks are really delicious. I wouldn't say any of them are very strong. The only one that is really, really strong is the margarita, and that one actually tastes really strong too. All the other cocktails taste really excellent, but I never really get a super strong buzz off of any of them. The food, I do think they shine. I think that the apps and small plates are really, really good. Overall, if you have time and there's no line, I would definitely go to Vanderpump and take some cute pictures, but it's not somewhere that I would wait a really long time to go to in comparison to the Peppermill or Parasol Down. I just don't think that's the main destination I would pick as far as a bar or lounge. So even though I really like Vanderpump inside Caesars, it's just not a must-do for me, and I think it's a tiny bit overrated. Okay, let's talk about Hell's Kitchen. Ugh. So I briefly mentioned this in my Caesars vlog that we had a bad experience and somebody was like, could you please go into further detail? I don't like to be super negative, but I do think that I really need to explain to you guys why I think Hell's Kitchen is really overrated. We were extremely excited to go here. We have had some good experiences at other Gordon Ramsay places and this place has been hyped up so much to us. We were left incredibly disappointed. So first of all, the service for us was bad. They lost our ticket for almost an hour, I wanna say.
Is that true?
And they were kind of apologetic about it, but they also sort of expected us to be like grateful when they offered us a free dessert, but it just kind of came off as like, oh, just be happy you're here.
Seriously.
I don't know, it was very strange. So they lost our ticket, and then the server was a little bit snooty, a little bit snobby. I just didn't feel super welcomed here. And the food was just okay. Some of the food was good, a lot of it was not good at all, like bad. And even if we'd had great service and good food, I still find the concept of this restaurant really strange. It feels like you're in a giant cafeteria. It almost reminds me of being in a restaurant in Disney World, where they're just trying to pack in as many bodies as physically possible and get them out. There's also no dress code here. And for me personally, when I'm paying for a $100 meal, I generally prefer to be a little dressed up and look a little bit nice. And so to have somebody next to you in like sandals and a tank top just kind of ruins the illusion of having fine dining. Overall, I just don't totally understand Hell's Kitchen. So for me, it's an absolute not must do. I actually don't recommend it at all. I think it's extremely overrated. Now, we're the only ones that had a bad experience, I would say, out of a lot of people, but I still think even if our experience was good, I still think it's overrated.
You surprise me to how shit you are.
Now, if you're a huge Ramsay fan, if you love Gordon Ramsay and you're like, well, I was really looking forward to that, two of my friends just came back from Vegas and they actually went to Gordon's Steakhouse there and they served the beef Wellington dish, which was the standout of all of the dishes there was the beef Wellington. They serve it at the steakhouse and they had rave reviews and they said their service was excellent. We've also eaten at Gordon Ramsay Burger. And even though the burgers are expensive, I think this place is really, really good and the food was good and the service was good. So there are other Ramsay options and I personally would just skip Hell's Kitchen. I really didn't like it. This is the one where I just feel like I had a really negative review for you guys. I think it's overrated. Okay, and the last one, number six, this one's kind of crazy, but I'm just gonna say it. I think the Las Vegas sign is overrated. I do. So we've been to Vegas so many times and we've never stopped to take a picture here because it's in the middle of a highway. So the Las Vegas sign is just out in the middle of nowhere past Mandalay Bay. So all the way on the south end of the strip where there's nothing after it. You have to get down there and park or you're gonna have to Uber there or take an incredibly long walk. Once you're there, you take your picture, and that's it. You're gonna have to walk all the way back, Uber all the way back, or drive all the way back, because there's nothing around it. And I just feel like everybody has a picture here, and there are so many awesome Instagram spots for you to take pictures in Las Vegas. I just don't think it is worth taking that 25 minutes out of your vacation to try to get down there and take a picture and then go back. Like, you're just gonna end up tired. I personally just don't get it. I think that you could take a picture in front of the Paris sign, the Bellagio fountains, inside the conservatory, at the flamingos. There's so many places you guys could take pictures that would look really cool and be great memories for the trip. And I just don't think the Las Vegas sign is one of them. So for me, I think it's a little bit of an overrated tourist destination. And to be fair, I love tourist stuff and I have nothing against being a tourist, but I just don't think it's worth going all the way down there to take a picture. Okay, so those are my list. I know some of them are super crazy for some of you guys. Please feel free to politely debate me in the comments and let me know I'm wrong and why. That's fine. That's the whole point of this video. And let me know if you do want to see the underrated list, because these are things that I feel like I'm the only person who talks about these. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that maybe this was helpful for someone who's coming on an upcoming trip to say, okay, well, I'll cross that one off my list because we have so many other things to do. Also, be sure to hit the subscribe if you're not a subscriber. And if you don't follow me on Instagram, you can go ahead and follow me there. I get DMs from you guys all the time and you can ask me questions. I can go into a little more depth for you. And thank you so much for watching and I will see you guys in my next video.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.